Und damit ein herzliches Willkommen und Hallo zu einem weiteren Part Let's Play Fake Grand Order. Ich bin es, einem Simafix, und wir bewegen uns hier auf das Finale des ersten Lost Beltes zu. Wir sind hier in Jagger Moskau und bewegen uns hier in Richtung des Baumes der Leere. Beim letzten Mal haben wir es hier geschafft, endlich diesen Mistviech, den Minotauren hier zu bezwingen. Atalanta ist nun wieder auf unserer Seite und Avispawn hat hier gesagt, dass er uns hier betrogen hat. Doch so halbwegs, könnte man nur sagen. Er hat zwar gesagt, dass er uns hier betrogen hat, aber dass er immer noch Ivan aufhalten will. Um das zu machen, muss er den ultimativen Golem erschaffen, den er aus dem Labyrinth des Minotaurus entwickelt. Dieser braucht aber einen Kern und dieser Kern wird er selbst sein. Avispawn hat sich jetzt hier selbst umgebracht und wir müssen natürlich nun schauen, was aus unserem Freund hier wird. Freund, Servant, Verräter, ich weiß es nicht, aber ich denke mal, wir werden es nun zusammen herausfinden. Es ist Zeit, endlich für die finale Schlacht gegen Ivan, den Schrecklichen, das Monster und der König des Lost Belt, Section 21, The Lightning Tsar Reigns. Und ich habe Angst, aber meine Decke schafft es schon. Ich hoffe, das ist ein weiblicher Ivan, Ivanka. I see. Ja, das war noch, was er beim letzten Mal gesagt hat, dass er auch Kinder für seine Experimente benutzt hat. Ist ja nicht so, als würde ich das nicht wissen aus Apocrypha, deswegen habe ich Avispawn ja nicht so ganz getraut. After I was summoned as a servant, I began killing people. I doubt I am the first dirty hands as a servant that were to determinedly kept clean in life. Once one has been summoned as a servant, bloodshed is all but inevitable, especially given how central it is to the Holy Grail Wars. They are, after all, events held for their sole purpose of fulfilling mages' desires. And in one such holy grail war, I proved to be the worst kind of servant imaginable. All I've ever desired to recreate the primordial man and save my persecuted people. I threw away the sense of pride and the morals that I held so dear, all in pursuit of that goal. I killed my own master, who was just a child. I only know about this from records of the event. I can't remember the name or face. Such a horrible deed. And I cannot remember anything about it. But the records speak for themselves. They tormented me, proving beyond any doubt I am just as driven my desires as any other ruthless mage. That can't be true. We can't rule it out. Speaking for myself, I don't really care about that too much. Whether a servant remembers or not probably depends on them, and the sort of memories they are dealing with. I know I don't care about remembering fighting in any boring ass war, but I'd at least like to remember saving the world. If you feel bad about knowing you killed a child at some point, I'd say that just proves that deep down you're really a good guy. But you're here now, to save all of humanity. You don't get to sacrifice yourself. Yes, I may just be making excuses. Nonetheless, right now, we don't need a servant. We need a giant. One that is powerful enough to stand up to the truly horrible beast of the Tsar. As for Kadok Zemlopus, a word of advice. Don't write him off. Don't underestimate him. If you do, you'll regret it.
Avispawn.
Master, I am sorry. But I'm afraid this is the only way I can be useful to humanity. I'll leave the giant's command in your hands. Good luck, Master. You have a long path ahead of you and difficult choices to make, but I believe in you. Fight hard, courageous young man. You're human, but I know you have the strength you need to fulfill your duty.
Auf Wiedersehen.
Aber vielleicht hat er uns hier die Hoffnung gegeben. Die Hoffnung hier, das Monster zu bezwingen.
Avispawn, I can't believe it. He didn't just use part of the Minotaur Labyrinth for a golem. He used all of it.
Das ist ein niemals endende Labyrinth. The hell? Where the shadow came from? Is that a golem? Did Avispawn make that?
Run away! This place is going to turn into a battlefield!
Hold it.
Schieß sie!
Don't point your gun at me. It makes me want to end you.
What? My gun.
You're with Caldea, aren't you?
That's right.
Why would Ajega help them? Are you a remnant of the rebel army?
No. Then again, I guess I am. I did think about rebelling for a little while. But I changed my mind as soon as I saw even the terrible in person.
I see. So you were dead, Jagger. I was told you were all but undone when the priest decided to make you look up in the Tsar. But it looks like you rather enjoyed it.
What?
It's okay. You needn't be afraid anymore. The disturbance will cause the Tsar to awaken. Which means that the Tree of Emptiness will finally start absorbing mana from the land.
What are you talking about? Did you say that thing is going to wake up?
That's right. I can see even though of that terrifies you. But it's okay. We're going to defeat even the terrible ourselves.
Also ihr Plan, alles auch der von Semloplus und natürlich hier der Verrat, den hier Adelante machen will, dient alles einem Ziel, even den Schrecklichen zu bezwingen.
What?
I said it. I finally said it. I feel so much better now. I've been holding that for a long time. We're going to destroy the Tsar. The last vestige of Russia in this world.
What are you talking about? Are you betraying the Tsar?
Well, that didn't take long. I suppose I should have expected that there. Nonetheless.
Und wenn der Tsar aufwacht, verschwinden sie.
Now that the Tsar is about to awaken from his dream, I'm afraid you, Pryniki, have outlived your usefulness.
This took place not too long ago, back when I had only just been summoned. At last, I will have the audience I desire. I can sense him here. Stand in my way, and I shall kill you as well. Now take me to see him, you swine in priest clothing. I'm impressed you get through the Opriniki and made your way here, especially with that pitiful phrase bird origin. Very well, out of respect for your hard work, I will grant you the audience with Amadeus that you desire. Besides, he told me to let you through himself. In fact, his exact words were, if a man claiming to be my friend should ask to see me, please show him the way. He has every right to be here, you see. Always smiling, the most innocent angelic smile I have ever seen.
Amadeus, Amadeus.
Amadeus, Amadeus. Amadeus, Amadeus, Amadeus. Oh, jetzt sind wir schon wieder am Falco. I must see you. I must speak with you. I want to ask you what purpose we were meant to serve by being summoned into this lost belt. Are we meant to kill one another? Or is only one of us meant to kill one another? Is this passion stirring in my heart meant to be offered to a friend? Or is it an iron stake meant to be driven into an enemy? I thought that once I saw you, I would know the answer. However, I must warn you before you see him. He is, after all, fruitfully exhausted. He has been performing his noble phantasm without rest for the last 2 months. I am afraid his spirit origin is more fragile now than the decaying flesh, and the flame of his soul has dimmed only as scant embers. Frankly, he is in no state to receive visitors. A dreadful sense of foreboding seized me. I knew from those words that something must be wrong, and yet I still saw him, even before I knew what that something was.
I thought that was you. I'd recognize those firm, uptight footsteps anywhere. Ah, the man in grey. Are you here to kill me?
Mozart, what did you lot to do this prodigious talent? As you can see, we've been having him play the piano, though. I must confess, without him, time to rest. But rest assured, we did not coerce him into doing so. He volunteered of his own accord after learning of the special circumstances here in Russia. I distinctly remember him saying, well, great, guess I'm just going to have to set a new record for longest performance of all time. This is madness. You're playing the piano and the rest of the orchestra all on your own? How have you been doing this for so long? You hate hard work. You grow bored almost at the drop of her head.
Well, that's not very nice. Sure, I'd much rather just play a single song, get paid, and go back to my life with leisure. But given who I'm playing for this time, even I can't help but to be motivated. Besides, the Tsar was one of the verge of waking up when I began to play. I didn't dare to give him anything but my best. He could easily end up grinding this entire country to a pipe if he were to wake up after all. What choice did I have but to ensure he kept dreaming sweet dreams? So, that's why you've been playing the piano? You mean a greedy miser like you has been playing his heart out here in the frigid cold for months to an end? For a demented old man who couldn't understand your worth of his life depend on it?
No need to be so rude to him. Though I will grant you that he's rather up there in years. The Tsar has been an excellent audience. He taught me my music was like a paradise itself. But I'm afraid I'm not at my limit. In fact, I won't be around much longer. The environment was just too much for a frail servant like me. I can't even move my fingers anymore. It's worse than the illness I contracted before I died the first time. Still, if I have to die again here, I don't want to do it without being useful in some way. So I thought you should kill me. I even taught Makaros, that was my condition for helping out. Come on. The Grand Duchess and the others are nowhere to be found. That is your chance. You do hate me enough to kill me, right? Then go on, just do it. Why would you just say that? Your skill is divine, a gift from God himself. And now you want me to kill you with my own hands? You want me to make those awful rumors the truth? How can you say that? Why not? If you hate me enough to kill me, go ahead and get it out of your system. Who knows? You might feel a lot better. Just don't expect it to save your life or anything. I might be a perilous genius, but there are some things even I can't help with.
Mozart!
Oops. Once I let myself relax, I guess I ended up like a puppet with its strings cut. I don't think I'd last another minute. This is always how it went with us, wasn't it? I'd show up unannounced, challenge you out of nowhere, then make impossible demands when I won. Why break with Pritterton now? Salieri, when this is all over, would you play Twinkle Twinkle Little Star for me?
What are you?
I knew it. It would come to this. I may not have any hope of surviving, but you still have a chance to win. Salieri, it's all about timing. Friends and enemies alike must work together, or no one will be able to defeat that thing. Salieri, you stay closer to me than anyone else. You kept on hating me, even knowing your hate would never be requited. I always appreciated that. So until the time to defeat the Tsar comes, I am going to leave this lullaby to you. Don't worry, this patron's ears aren't exactly the sharpest. You and I may notice the many minute difference in our performances, but he never will. So before I go, I'm going to put a curse on you.
Stop! You can't!
Now you must be Mozart for a while.
Yeah, Mozart! New!
Ah, what an incredible dull job that was. But then again, I guess it had its moments, seeing the greatest monster in the world. Dreaming to the sound of my piano. It was almost like I was holding the world on the palm of my tiny hand. And that wasn't too bad at all. Und so geht der Kampf zu Ende. Ohne, dass beide einen Finger gezogen.
That's right. I remember now. Hi. Now go ahead and play your Requiem as much as you like. You may play it for Amadeus or the Tsar, or for yourself when you lost sight of who you are. You will find an instrument right over there.
Also Mozart warnende Singularität hat hier Salieri mehr oder weniger herausgefordert. Aber was ich ganz schön fand, wirklich, dass es, wie gesagt, es ist ja nur ein Rufmord im Endeffekt, dass Salieri hier ihn getötet hat. Dass er hier natürlich sagt, eine Krankheit hat mich getötet. Und auch wenn alle denken und du selber denkst, dass du mich tötest, es war nicht mehr so. Doch wenn du dich besser fühlst, mach es. Aber ich zwinge dich leider nun hier, meine Aufgabe zu Ende zu bringen, welche es nur kann. So schön, Mann. So schön, Mann.
That's ridiculous. What are you thinking? Are you completely insane?
I've been quite sane for a long time now, Jagger. This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. We now have Kalir, those servants, Kerok, myself, and a giant. The giant is from a realm, from a time that demonic beasts could not hope to touch. So I'm going to cooperate with the boy and his team. Together, I'm certain they will achieve a miraculous victory.
So you're gonna take that mountain of a Tsar?
That's right. Otherwise, this world will never be saved. Everything we do for the sake of this world. Oh, yes. I must forget. There's a very important detail you should know. Do you know what those devils at Kalia are attempting to do?
Huh?
I believe they mean to restore this planet to its proper form, in order to restore humanity. But that doesn't mean you Jagger are going to benefit from that. Your mistaken history, your erroneous path, will merely be pruned away. I take it you know that human from Kalia well. Then please, tell me everything you can about him. Does he really know what is he should be doing?
Und die Opiniki lösen sich auf, was nur bedeutet, dass der Zar aufwacht. The Tsar is waking up. The Tsar is waking up. After all this time, the Tsar is waking up. Now it is time for us to move on. Glory to the great Tsar. Das Monster erwacht. Ivan der Schreckliche. Vor denen selbst Woodtime, Canis und alle Servants, die ihn gesehen haben, in Angst und Schrecken liegen.
The Lucifer's Bird Origin Reading and Miyaga Mosca are dropping like flies. I think the Opriniki are disappearing.
As we expected, once a battle began in Jagger Moscow, it was only a matter of time before the Tsar woke up. I will say that I certainly didn't expect this to begin moving.
What is? Are my eyes deceiving me? Is the monitor broken? Is this one of the Winch's particular jokes? What's going on here? Holmes, what is that thing on the monitor? Huge, doesn't even begin to cover it, for that matter. Is it just me, or are we headed straight toward it?
Stop the vehicle! Manier! Hit the brakes!
What could we hope to accomplish by going there?
Nothing, that's what. We'll just end up a stain on the bottom of the thing's foot.
Give Maxi the order to retreat. Forget about investigating the Tree of Emptiness or whatnot.
We are leaving Russia, right now. If we must risk our lives, I'd rather take my chance on Zero-Zeal.
That's impossible. We have team members in Jagger Moscow. We can't retreat now. That thing could catch them and crush them in just a few steps, well before they have a chance to escape. No, our condition for victory are unchanged. Defeat Ivan the Terrible and capture the Crypta. If we are to accomplish those goals, we will need everything we have at our disposal. How are things shaping up over there, Da Vinci? Skip your opinions on and just give me the numbers.
Nordnog's exoskeleton is operating within expected parameters. Internal pressure regulation, combustion and weaponry are all good to go. Armor check out. Ready to transport here at any time. Beyond that, it all depends on how mentally prepared he is.
Just the number, Da Vinci. Mr. Menirio, take us into Jagger Moscow Western Area. By my estimation, we should rendezvous with the investigation team in 10 minutes and 30 seconds.
Stop! Damn you! Stop! Phoenix or not, I won't be able to make it out this alive.
Du stehst doch dann aus der Asche aus, oder? Einmal tot und dann nochmal aufstehen.
Ivan the Terrible is an ordinary Jagger. Long ago, an ancient primordial beast was discovered in Russia's tundra. By merging with his creature, Ivan the Terrible began a period of growth. And perhaps due his heroic temperament or his imperial bloodline, that growth continued to this day. It is said that mammoths and saber-toothed tigers went extinct when their tusks and fangs grew too large.
Ein Mammut? Säbelzahntiger?
But Ivan the Terrible has moved beyond such a concern. He is no longer beloved or worshipped. Now he is no more than a horrific monster. Keep playing with every ounce of hatred you can muster, Salieri. Now that his nap is over, the Tsar finally about to come face to face with reality.
Makaris, oder Kotomini, du wolltest es.
The Tsar's dream is ending. He is about to wake up. We are born from the Tsar's dreams. Once he awakens, we return to dust. Glory to the Tsar. Long live the Tsar.
Es wird wahrscheinlich bei Billy sein, ne?
Hä? Dobrynicki are turning into dust?
Does this rumbling mean he is waking up? Or what about the golem?
It's still coming together. It's somebody is being assembled piece by piece, like muscles growing on a skeleton. Holy shit! That is huge!
What's wrong?
That's just some sort of joke.
Doesn't look like it.
I've awoken from my dream. I see now what is happening in the world. It seems my dreams for Russia are yet to come fruition. I must eradicate the countless traitors and expand my territory. My nap is over. The time has come for me to make a stand. So he is finally awakened. Ivan the Terrible is said to have once moved the capital of Russia from Moscow to the city of Alexandrov in the northeast. But that city is no longer exist in this lost belt. It disappeared from this world as Ivan the Terrible continued to sleep to mutate, to undergo further growth and mutation. Indeed, that mountain creature is what remains of the man who fell back into a dream after his return from Alexandrov. Ivan the Terrible is no longer a man, nor even a jagger. He is a beast of the gods, the engrossed culmination of his many dreams. Anastasia! Anastasia! The Dobrynicki taught me what you said.
Oh my god! Er ein riesiges Mammut! Ein Bärgroßes!
Is it true you have you betrayed me? Where the peace and happiness you taught me of nothing but lies? Tell me! Anastasia!
What is that? Don't tell me that! It's all furious. We're all doomed. Oh, God. We can't defeat that. Nobody could. You should never have gone against it. Keep your distance. Do not get caught up in the civilians' evacuation. Never mind the lines between rebel army and civilian. Now. Keep them in line and get as far away from here as you can.
Got it.
Jetzt weiß ich, wieso Paxi so viel Angst hatte. I fought both demonic beasts and giants before, but...
Das ist ein anderes Limit.
I've never seen one of this size. I think he would even give the gods of Olympus true forms a run for their money.
I've heard there were giant folk all over the place back in the Age of Gods. But at least where I lived, they only grew to be about 10 meters at best.
See, this is why I told you not to wake the Tsars up. There's nothing anyone can do against a monster the size of a mountain.
Excuse me? But you never told us he was literally a mountain-sized monster.
If you just mentioned that one tiny detail earlier, we'd have been a lot more prepared for this sight. Besides, he's not a mountain. He's a mammoth, a kind of giant elephant.
Huh? Elephant? What's an elephant? Some sort of animal?
Alright, I guess all those elephants in this world went extinct too long ago. I don't know how I would go about describing one more. Anyway, the point is, he's an elephant, not a mountain. A really, really big elephant, but still an elephant.
Wie ein Elefant im Porzellanladen.
You mean these elephant creatures are common in your world? Wow,
ist doch gar keine so schöne Welt, aber vielleicht nicht ganz in der Größe.
Do you think we can beat him? Natürlich können wir das.
It doesn't matter whether we can or not. We've just got to fight him, no matter what.
Schlagen wir ins Gesicht, komm!
Now that's how a general ought to be. Keep an eye on the big picture from the top of the golem for us, okay?
Well, be counting on you to use a command spell and play a trump card when the time is right. That said, he's not actually seeing us right now, is he? He's calling for Anastasia, saying something about her betraying him.
That's because she did. Kadok. Jetzt verbünden wir uns echt mit dem.
This works out nicely. If you are still alive, then help us out. You will help us, right?
You're going to fight even the Terrible too?
At least you're not a complete idiot. The Oprinniki are gone, and even the Terrible's awake. All that's left now is to take him down.
You're after our golem, huh?
That's right. In this rush, even the Terrible's neither human nor Jagger, nor even a rogue spirit. He's a walking natural disaster, an active volcano that only causes destruction whenever he wakes up. It's better for everyone if we get rid of him once and for all. We need to build a new Russia, and your arrival here gave us the perfect chance to do it. Don't get it? Come on, really. Ah, fine, I explain. When you got here, I saw a chance. Long time coming, but I saw it, so I took it. I used you to further my own ends. No, I don't feel bad about it. Get with it, Maxi.
Well, that's an awfully roundabout way to doing things. If you just asked nicely from the start instead of being a jackass, Maxi would have been glad to help.
I'm not here to make friends. My only goal is to get more game pieces I can use to beat him, understand? So I set up a game board. One where the rebel army, Caldea, Anastasia and me would all have no choice but to defeat him. Well, Maxi, you're used to this sort of thing by now, right? Let's go save this world. Alright. Good answer. Even the Terrible's got at least one weakness. He's slow.
Does that even matter?
I'm a fair wolf on this. He may not be as big as Daiborachi, but we're still talking a literal mountain size here. Of course he's gonna be slow.
It means he can't keep up with your servants. If nothing else, you can... You know he can't dodge your attacks. He can't fly. He packs tremendous force. He can cause an avalanche with a single step. He can even slam his trunk into the ground in place of an anti-army noble phantasm. His only weak point is the crown on his head. That is his real body.
Real body?
Try enhancing your vision. You should be able to see it even in this blizzard.
I don't know how to do that.
Amateur.
Yeah, there it is. Doesn't look any bigger than a pea from here, but still probably monstrous compared to us.
It's gonna be tough to get there. Even running up his trunk at full speed won't be enough to keep from swatted before one of us reaches the top. Are you all here? With matters having come to a head, we must now put our all alliance aside. Disaster has struck, and the Tsar has awoken. He won't stop until he destroys everything. I understand why you might bear a grudge against me, but right now, we all need to work together.
Anastasia, the Tsar's after you. So?
Yes, I hold him back with my noble phantasm for as long as this possibly can.
After that, it'll all depend on how motivated you are. Can you do this?
I have no right to be a ruler. I hate the people. I hate this land. Everything I cared about is long gone. I don't even know why I became a servant in the first place. I barely even remember my own life anymore. All I have in my head now is knowledge of this lost belt. Still, I did love my family, and they loved Russia. So, I will not shirk my duties. I refuse to drown in my grief, or to flail around in desperation. I will simply do everything in my power to eliminate even the Terrible, no matter how hard it may be.
There you have it. Please help us. You do want to save the world, don't you?
Guess we've just gotta go along with this, huh? Jeez.
No word from the water, Maxi. Ah, the comms not working right.
Haben schon was anderes vor.
Well, we'll just have to decide this for ourselves, Aldo.
This feeling. I don't think I'll be able to stick around here for much longer.
Now what? Never mind, let's just get going.
Guess Billy's not gonna make it. Might as well give Sunshine a message for him in the meantime. Alright, do it.
Anastasia, I beg you off with my command spells.
Atalanta, I'm sure you can tell this is no time to be worrying about a rebellion.
I know.
Then you go on attack. You should be plenty enough to provoke him.
Wir laufen eigentlich schön in seine Falle. Wir tun uns jetzt nämlich auspowern und dann am Ende greift er uns dann an.
Show him your speed. Show him how high and far you can jump. After that, I don't care. Figure the rest out on your own. Come on, Anastasia. The Tsar's waiting for you.
The fire inside him may be a little more than petulant embers, but it never goes out. He is indifferent, jealous, and hateful in equal measure. How wonderful a human. Master of Caldea, do you really think you can defeat my master? No need to answer now. You can tell me later.
Wir müssen ja danach gegen sie kämpfen.
Okay, let's get going. Master, we will be counting on you to back us up. It looks like this new phantasm golem answers to your commands. So make sure you have it put up a good fight.
Okay, guess I'll be off too. See you later, Maxie. Be careful to stay put. I use a lot of arrows and they do not care what they hit.
What I tell you, Maxie, this world is finished now. We still haven't fought him. You're actually going to fight with this huge golem? I can't tell. None of the servants or even this golem can match the Tsar. You really think you can beat him just by working together? You're out of your damn mind. The Tsar is the strongest being in this world, period. That's why it's impossible to beat him. Deep down, you know that's true, don't you, Maxim? When I saw that thing and heard him speak, that was it, I was done. I mean, come on. Who'd believe they could rebel against that kind of ruler? You think you can beat that thing, but you can't. He's a god, a real flesh and blood god. He's the ultimate being. There's nothing that can stop him from doing anything he wants. So, we Jagger have no choice but to submit to him. Come on, you get it, right? I can still move, so I'm not done.
What?
People are counting on me to win this.
What?
So, liebe Leute, bevor wir jetzt aber hier weitermachen und hier zum Kampf uns mit Ivan dem Schrecklichen anlegen werden, machen wir jetzt erstmal einen kleinen Cut, Leute, und dann beim nächsten Mal wird es wahrscheinlich dann richtig losgehen. Sehr, sehr cool bis jetzt alles. Dann bis zum nächsten Mal. Auf Wiedersehen. Ciao.